Hello YouTube, and welcome back again to Keyforge with KevBot. Today we have another gameplay video for you guys. This time it's going to be episode 7. So we've already got 7 of these down in the books, hoping to finish them up in the next week or two. So we have today T. Neratius, Star Guards, Clean Cooper. So I played one game with this one so far. It seems okay. Something I am a little bit concerned about is creature count. Only 14 creatures is a little on the slow side, but we'll see how it goes. Starting off with Logos, we've got some new cards here we haven't seen yet. Help from Future Self. So this one's an action. Search your deck and discard pile for Time Traveler. Reveal it, put it in your hand, and then shuffle your discard into your deck. So we'll go ahead and look at Time Traveler as well here. So this is a 2-power creature. It gets you an amber, and you get to drop 2 cards off. It seems pretty sweet. And then you can also action to shuffle it back into your deck. So this seems pretty good. I mean, it's a good way to get value over time. Other than that, not a whole lot of exciting stuff happening in Logos. What about Mars? We've got Martians Make Bad Aliens. It's a new action as well. Play, reveal your hand, purge each revealed non-Mars creature, and gain an amber for each card purchased with. Seems pretty good, actually. But again, we only have 14 creature cards here, so I don't know if we even want to be discarding those. But we'll see how it goes. Orbital Bombardment is great removal. And Phosphorus Stars, stunning a bunch of creatures. Seems good. Sanctum, we've got a new card here, Doorstep to Heaven. Each player with 6 or more amber is reduced down to 5. Seems really good. It also gets you an extra amber. So even in the case that your opponent's not at that stage, you still get some value for that card. You also have sort of a creature version of it in Gatekeeper. Same thing, 7 more amber, capture all but 5 of it. So some great ways to put your opponent back from forging the keys. But we'll get right into it here, okay? Alright, so we're in game here. We have the choice. As normal, we'll always choose to go first until I can prove otherwise. Let's see what we've got here. I mean, we've got a pretty stacked hand with just Sanctum and Logos, so just keeping here seems pretty good. I can go Sanctum into Sanctum. Yeah, so we're going to keep here. Oh my gosh! Guys, how many times am I going to do this crap? They need to change that. Alright, okay, so this seems not good, but we'll go ahead and make the best of it. So I sort of just want to get my artifact out here. Not going to probably be playing it soon, but if I happen to drop all of my, probably going to go Logos next turn. Yeah, go Logos next turn, and then I can drop have a bunch of Mars in my hand and activate this. Seems okay. We're just giving our opponent a little bit of handicap, right? We can't give him the full experience. Alright, this is the problem. So, don't really have any way to deal with this, but I guess just dump our hand and look for more Mars creatures to kill it. So, that's the plan. Go Logos here. Capturing one's pretty nice, though. Fogify so he can't fight next turn. Don't really want to save this card. We'll phase shift and then go into this guy as well. So, yeah, probably I'm going to wait on Mars. Okay. Well, if he's just going to do that, well, that still doesn't kill this guy. Okay, Shadow Self. Pretty big problem for us. How does this work? damage dealt to its neighbors is it doesn't. So we just have to start getting rid of that. But I sort of just want to play these Logos cards and ignore it for now. Because just playing one card seems really bad, so we'll take the chance. So let's see what this does first. Okay, another Dexter. That's pretty nice, actually. Then we get to archive a card. Go ahead and archive the doorstep here, because we're definitely going to be wanting to take advantage of that once he gets to more than 6. And we're putting the pressure on him, actually. We're up to 4 amber, so looking good. Okay, we're finally at a spot where we're happy to go Mars next turn. Plus, we have more removal, so hopefully we can get rid of his Hunting Witch finally. I can do 1, 2, 3, 4 with my Mother Gun, and then using this, I can do 1, 2, 3, 6. So we have 4, not quite enough to do everything we want here. So now he's putting the pressure back on us. I think we just have to go Mars here and start getting rid of this Hunting Witch is just way too good for him. Oh, what do I have in the archives? Oh, crap. Forgot we had that. Oh, well, we'll use it later. So I'll go ahead and activate this. And then we'll also kill it using bombardment, revealing these. Okay, finally that's gone. So I don't have any robots, so I can just use... Do we even want to use my Imply Blasts here? Yeah, because we want to go sink in the next turn, probably. And this will get us up to 6. So hopefully we can trade keys with him this turn. Alright, this is interesting here. So again, we have this Martians Make Bad Allies card. So we could get 1, 2, 3, 4 amber straight up by discarding all these creatures. But I sort of don't really like the idea of that. Maybe using... Oh my god, a second Hunting Witch? Come on, man. Oh no, he just reaped Fogbane. That's fine. As long as he doesn't... Okay, he doesn't have more follow-up, so... We're actually okay here, because we can just draw up a big Sanctum hand. Not yet. Play all my Sanctum stuff. And make sure I order the taunt to protect these two guys. So we're protecting a Grey Monk who's getting everybody armor, and then just protecting one of the merchants, because why not? I guess I could have left that spot open to protect a better creature, but we're okay here. This is good because we still have 2 Sanctum cards, and we can bring in our Doorstep to Heaven this turn, assuming he's going to go up to 6. Yeah, this is really good. So we might be turning the corner here. Poltergeist. Sure. Okay, yeah, this is plenty good for us. So definitely going Sanctum here. Then we will take our archive cards in hand. So we'll use this first, do the ordering correctly. Then how are we going to attack? We're just going to clear his board probably. This guy, full heal creature. Okay, no, shield of justice seems great as well here. So go ahead and fight, kill this. Go ahead and fight, kill this. Go ahead and fight, kill this. We'll reap. And then play another Sanctum creature. Alright. So yeah, we're sort of at the spot here where we can definitely get ahead. Because unless he can deal with our board somehow, we have a combo here that's going to allow us to remove oh my gosh, Gateway to Dis. Gosh darn it, man. Okay. Alright, well, this is actually okay, because we can just use his key to kill his thing here. So, yeah, definitely going Logos here. So, get rid of his creature. Grab our Time Traveler. This guy's pretty sweet. Play him. Play Bobble. Play this thing. Alright, looking good. So we're exactly on 6. It's really where we want to be. Forcing him to deal something. I mean, he's got Shedda, so he probably has something, but that was really nice, getting rid of his key to Dis and getting rid of his creature. He's got so much value off his loss in the woods cards this game. It's been pretty crazy. Okay, so we have the option of making 1, 2, 3, but probably don't want to do that. I'll probably just be playing all these cards. Yep. Definitely want to be protecting this guy. You show me play an artifact, game one. I don't really care about protecting this. Oh, he can attack through it, but so we'll go ahead and just so he can't get the free trade there, we'll protect it. All right, let's see. So he's still on his chain reduction, so that's been nice for me, at least. That's unfortunate. Let's see what we want to do here. Go Sanctum, we can get an extra thing for my artifact. Oh, we can ramp up to 3 and go straight up to 6. That seems pretty good. And then next turn we can just Martians, hopefully, and have enough. I think that's the plan. Because right, we have 2 of these merchant guys and then play a artifact. So that'll give us 2, 3, 4, 5. Seems okay. So play this out first, so it's in the correct order. Then we'll play our artifact. Wait. I think that's bugged, right? Should I have gone to Amber? Yeah. Okay, yeah, so apparently this trigger didn't trigger. So we just got her 2 Amber then. Then what else do we want to do? Sort of want to deal with this pit demon, but he's probably not going to want to go dis again. So I'm sort of just want to read. I mean, because if he goes dis again here, then, I mean, he gets to read twice. I don't know what else he's going to have in dis. You know, he just played it last turn, so he's not going to be inclined to do it again. At this point, we're sort of racing him. So next turn, really want to be getting up to 6 somehow and prevent him from getting there if possible. Because we're ahead right now. We're both at 2 keys. We have a slightly bigger board, but we're more centered onto Sanctum. And I know we have a bunch more artifacts in our deck. Uh-oh. What's he got? Silvertooth. That's just a 2/2. Poison Wave, sure. So did he do Reaped? Sure. Heat of Darkness. Okay. So we want to push the button here if we can. Just making sure we're getting up to 6. I mean, if we just go Sanctum, it's probably the safest play. Just get a bunch of Amber. Question is, do we want to kill some of his stuff? Probably. Just to decrease his chances of reaping up to 6 next turn. This is a critical turn here. Or we just straight up reap up to 9. If we do that, 5, 8, 6, 7. So if we just straight up reap, it plays around bait and switch. But he might have like a prevent something to prevent me from forging next turn. Either way, I think I'm going Sanctum here. So, definitely playing this guy. And the question is, I mean, if we just reap 3 times, we'd go up to 8. Then 4, 7, 5, 6, 6, 5, that's not good. But then he can pit demon. I'm thinking I do want to kill this pit demon here. What do I kill it with, though? Probably just one of these merchants. I mean, I could get the favorable trade here. That seems okay, actually. And then just reap up. Okay, heal 2 damage from a creature. Awesome. So I'm all the way healed up. Oh, yes! Doorstep to Heaven. Okay. Great draw here. Okay, this is good. Oh, this is so good. This is the perfect draw for us. So it's action. Each player with six or more gets reduced down to five. So it's going to reduce. Well, we're not even going to get reduced, probably. Yep. Okay. So this has elusive, and that does not. So I think I'm just going to put the pressure on again. I'll probably kill this silver tooth here. But other than that, I think I'm just going to reap. And going Sanctum. And then just reap up here. I mean, I could kill these two things, or one of these things. Is there any point in doing that? I mean, he probably just blew all of his steel mechanic. I'm just gonna reap up here, I think. This is an interesting dilemma. Actually, on the off chance he has like the Keyforge card, I'm going to kill his Niflheim so he can't reap with it next turn. So what has the most armor? This. Okay, so I'll reap here. Reap here. Fight this guy. Reap here. And then heal up. So again, I did that because if he had a way to generate an amber and then use the Keyforge, if he had one amber in hand and the Keyforge card. Okay, what's he got here? Then I could have played around that. Nice! We did it! Awesome game, guys. Jeez, that was a close one. Yeah, GG's, man. Holy crap. So yeah, we got there. We just got to a point where we had the Sanctum board laid out, and we just got so much advantage. So that's the thing, guys. Especially if you have some of those cards that steal. I mean, we had Gatekeeper in hand, too. That's a good thing about Sanctum, is they have ways to prevent your opponent from getting keys, you know? That's so important to gameplay. So we'll take it back to the overview. So we saw Help from Future Self. That was pretty good, right? It was basically just another copy of Time Traveler that got us an extra amber. So that was really nice. Not too much else from Logos. That was great. Didn't really get an opportunity to make use of Martians to make bad aliens. So this is probably not like a great card, I'm guessing. Unless you have a lot of... It's like a way to finish the game, I guess, if you have the right hand. But didn't use a whole lot of Mars stuff either, you know? Didn't draw a whole lot of my creatures. Orbital Bombardment's a good card. Helped us clear out that Shadow Self. But the big... the savior of the day for us was Sanctum. Doorstep to Heaven was great. That card won us the game, basically. And then just all these good creatures, man. Sanctum just has a lot of good creatures if you get them out all at the same time. They did wipe our board once, but after that we rebuilt and they couldn't really do anything to us, right? So great game there, but hope you guys did enjoy this latest episode. Just want to remind you guys, do please, if you guys enjoy the content, like, subscribe, definitely comment. Everything helps me out so much, guys. And if you guys have any more videos you want to see, I know I just uploaded that analysis type video, my top Keyforge power rankings for this at this time. I know it's way too early, but wanted to get that out for you guys. So hope you guys have a great afternoon, have a great day, have a great week, and good luck out there battling in the Crucible.